This is 11 gauge hot rolled steel here with the mill scale cleaned. We're going to compare ER70S-2 to S-6 to ER309. I'll be using the prime weld TIG 225 today, set at 109 amps.
Full 109 amps and I went full pedal.
This is the standard cup that came with the torch. I like stubby hardware. I think we've got the absolute best stubby gas lens kit on the market because we include these Furic gas lenses where you can use clear cups or ceramic cups, and you can build on this kit without having to buy new Furic adapter kits. A number 7 cup is about right for this joint. 20 CFH is plenty. I've got my stick out just a little bit longer than it really needs to be, but I don't want the cup to block the arc shot. This is ER70S-2 first here. No big surprises here. This is kind of the bread and butter rod. I use this for years and years on steel and chromoly. I like it. It's relatively cheap. It's readily available. Not much of a reason not to use it. It seems to really kind of stick where you put it, and so it's not as fluid as the ER70S-6, but that's not always a bad thing. Especially on a fillet weld like this, you don't want that puddle just wandering, flowing all around. You do want it to wet in. It looks like that did pretty okay. We're going to compare the ER70S-6 in just a second. Here's a 30-second tip for you, though. Do you notice how that filler rod is just balling up and blobbing into the puddle? That's because I'm using way too long of an arc. I'm using 160 amps here on quarter-inch steel, and the only difference I did was I tightened the arc length up. Look how much better it's going right there. A tight arc really helps. Okay, now back to the comparison. This is the ER70S-6 rod. For MIG welding, the manufacturers say that S-6 works better on dirtier steels. For TIG welding, I haven't noticed a lot of difference. It's a little bit more fluid, but once things settle down right here, it pretty much welds like the S-2 in this application over nice clean steel. Again, the differences are subtle. I can kind of notice when I dip rod in that the puddle kind of flows out just a little bit better, a little easier, but sometimes you want that, sometimes you don't. Either way, it's flowing into the root like it should, and it's doing a pretty good job, and it looks really almost identical to the ER70S-2. Not much difference that I can tell. I've got my post-flow gas set on about 10 seconds, so I'm in the habit of just hovering over that end of the weld while that post-flow times out. And those are the settings I used.
On a T-joint like this, the differences in S2 and S6 are very subtle, but where there really seem to be a difference is in an open root situation where the backside is exposed to atmosphere. The fluidity of that S6 seems to really make a difference on open roots.
There's quite a bit of difference in ER70S-2 and S6 on an open root, and you'll notice that if you have a little bit too tight of a gap or something like that, the S6 will go in there, where sometimes the S2 just won't penetrate, won't break the walls down. So there's some subtle differences, and I notice more of a difference on open roots than anywhere else. Well, let's go ahead and finish this up and weld the last couple of inches.
For this last weld, we're going to use 309. That's a whole different animal. 309 is used mostly for welding stainless to carbon steel, especially in pipe welding. But it's a very useful rod for a lot of other things. It's useful for when you don't know the exact composition of the steel you're doing, like when you're modifying a wrench, things like that. But where I found it really helpful, over the years, I've had to do a lot of repairs on things like injection molds. And so a lot of times they'd have rubber or plastic impregnated in some little crack or seam. And if you lit up on it with a steel rod like S2 or S6, it would bubble and you get porosity and you have to chase that porosity out with a die grinder. I just found that 309 worked great for those type of repairs. I wouldn't use it indiscriminately on carbon steel as a crutch necessarily, but it sure does work.
Still at 109 amps, full pedal, I'm using 1/16th diameter on all these welds. That's 1.6 millimeter. And this is 11 gauge hot rolled steel with the mill scale ground off clean. This actually looks a little bit more like that ER70S-6 puddle than the S2, but I'm doing the same thing. I'm using the same heat. I think I'm going just a little bit faster here because the 309 has just a slightly lower melt point than carbon steel. And so, you know, you don't really need quite as much heat usually. I could have bumped it down 5 or 10 amps and been fine. But again, that last little bit doesn't look tremendously different than the first two sections. I probably made some adjustments along the way without even realizing it.
Hey, listen, I support these videos with my online store at weldmonger.com. We've got filler metal in stock. If you're curious about trying some ER70S-6, 309, or 312, thanks for watching. I'd appreciate it if you visit my store, weldmonger.com. See you next time.